Thank you very much for joining us. Storm Watch 9 weather on the web. As we advance towards the end of this week, the weather pattern becomes a little bit more on the tricky side, although up until Thursday night, it's relatively tranquil, quiet, and seasonably chilly for the overnight into the day tomorrow. Some lingering flurries north will give way to some dry conditions during part of tomorrow morning. Then, upper-level system will race in tomorrow afternoon into Friday. Clouds will advance, and there's a chance of flurries or light snow showers scattered about the state during the day on Friday with a very light accumulation. Most accumulation should be under 2 inches of snow, so about a dust into an inch in many spots. Then it gets very tricky for Friday night through part of Saturday afternoon as another area of disturbed weather tries to move in from the south, could trigger more snow over parts of the state during that time. Right now, the odds favor that staying just to our south, but again, things could change. Plenty of time for that to happen. Right now, frigid parts of northeastern North Dakota, northwestern parts of Minnesota, seasonably mild across the deep south, right in the middle, seasonable temperatures, which is where we'll see them over the next several days. Now, here's where the plot thickens a little bit. We have energy in the Midwest, more energy in the Rockies, all of this racing towards the East Coast. What's going to happen is a major storm will crank up off the Carolinas and the Virginias tonight and tomorrow morning, and then race towards the Canadian Maritimes Friday into Saturday. That's a certainty. All the heavy moisture stays off to our east. But the upper-level system, the parent low, if you will stall over the eastern Great Lakes. And right in the middle is where we have to track a narrow band of snow and see where that actually sets up. Probably won't know that for sure till late Thursday night or sometime on Friday. In the meantime, fair skies develop tonight. Clouds and flurries linger up north. Sun gives way to clouds on Thursday, but it should be a dry day. Notice with an onshore breeze, weak system from the west, bands of snow showers or flurries on Friday. Again, a general dusting to an inch, inch and a half in spots. Then on Saturday, here is that band. Major storm with heaviest rain and snow offshore. Parent low back in the Great Lakes. And here is that band we'll have to track. Right now, just to our south, if it wobbles close enough, we could be talking about a band of moderate to heavy snow during a time Friday night to part of Saturday. After that, late Saturday into Sunday, it dries out, turns windy, seasonably chilly, and still windy and bright on Monday.